felt. I tried to be chill, but you're so hot that I melt. I fell right through the cracks, and now I'm trying to get back. Before the cool done run out, I'll be giving it my bestest, and nothing's gonna stop me but divine intervention. I reckon it's again my turn to win some more, learn some, but I won't hesitate no more, no more. It cannot wait, I'm yours. Well, open up your mind and see like me. Open up your plans and damn, you're free. I look into your heart and you'll find love, 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 love. Listen to the music of the moment, dance and sing. We're just one big family, and it's our God intended right to be loved, love, 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 love. So I won't hesitate no more, no more. It cannot wait, I'm sure. There's no need to complicate, our time is short. This is our fate, I'm yours. Do you want to come scooch on over closer, dear? Whisper in your ear, oh yes, love, 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 love you, love.
Ladies and gentlemen, friends and family, here they are, Mr. and Mrs. Adams. Yeah. Yeah. He's not going to step on Andrea's dress at all. Here they are, their first dance as husband and wife, Adam and Andrea Lindsay. One more time. Yeah. Yeah.
Our love is unconditional. We knew it from the start. I see it in your eyes, you can feel it from my heart. From here on after, let's stay the way we are right now, and share all the love and laughter that a lifetime will allow. I cross my heart true. In all the world, starts to storm. You've got the promise of my love to keep you warm.
Well, this, we've all been, can everybody hear well?
Well, it's for the report.
It's for the video.
It's for here.
Oh.
It's for the video.
Yeah. Come on, Fred, do it up,
Ben. Okay, well, I'll speak up. Well, then I'll try. As many of you know, our families, Lindsay's and Nagy's, come from a Christian heritage and principles from the Bible. The Proverbs give many basic instructions for life and how to respond when people get in the way of our plans. These include, it is not wise to show annoyance at once, like immediately. It is to one's honor to avoid strife, but every fool is quick to quarrel. Fools give full vent to their rage, but the wise bring calm in the end. Adam and Andrea, with God's help, you will grow in patience and kindness. Although it will seem difficult at times, turn off the scoreboard. A football coach that I heard of used to, when the team lost bad, kept the losing score on the scoreboard during practice for the next week to remind the team of their failure. While that sounds like a good strategy for a football team, it is a terrible strategy in marriage. When your spouse upsets you or fails you in some way, don't keep drawing attention to the failure. Turn off the scoreboard. The Bible says, love keeps no record of wrongs. We should remember to forgive one another. That's kind of our words to you. I think if I had have had the opportunity to write what we heard earlier at the church, I would have added in there that Adam and Andrea never get mad at each other when one catches the fish and the other doesn't that day. All the best, you guys.
Yay, all right. And this is a microphone for the camera, so you kind of need to hold it up around there.
A mom is protective of her children. And when Andrew and Adam started dating, I started watching Adam to see if he would be a good choice for Andrea if it happened to be someday that he would possibly become her husband. My observations are that Adam is a kind, compassionate, caring person. He is a hard worker and will be supportive of Andrea in every way. I believe they are a good match, as Andrea is also kind, compassionate, and caring, and supportive as well. Today I'm wishing Adam and Andrea all the best in a long and happy marriage.
Before I begin, I want to say thank you to all the people like Leah and all the hosts tonight. Henry, including you back there. And so thank you to everybody. So, 3 minutes. All right, I know. So as you guys know, I'm Adam's brother, and I'm his younger brother. And one thing about being a younger brother, which is really good, is that you get to learn from your older siblings. Sometimes that's direct, other times it's just by watching and watching their experiences. One of those experiences... One of those experiences was when I was a kid. And I learned that when you jump off of the roof, I learned by watching him, when you jump off of the roof into the swimming pool, don't videotape it. Because then mom and dad will find out. So me and my buddies, we appreciated that lesson. So thank you.
Anything to help.
But about learning from you though, brother, I have learned over the years that my brother doesn't give up. Honestly, whether it be on career or finding the one that you're going to spend the rest of your life with in marriage, you haven't given up. My brother and I are very different in many ways, but the fact that we're brothers is never going to go away, and I'm very thankful that he can't take that away, even if I'm lost or something. So, Adam, I want to say thank you for helping teach me to not give up in different aspects of life. And regards to fishing, you guys, I think, have both found a wonderful catch. So I simply want to say, whatever you got in your hand, this might be a little cliche, but it's the truth. So simply to not giving up, and to Adam and Andrea.
Andrea!
I know you're not supposed to do two, but I did. All right, so thank you, everybody.
Hi everyone. If you guys haven't seen me around at the barbecue, we're running around this week with the bride and the other bridesmaids. I just wanted to first of all say thank you to the both of you for inviting us to share in your special day today. It means the world to us to be able to come here to Maui and enjoy the beach and the sun and sand, and none of us would be here without you two. I've known the bride since I was 15 years old, so I've been able to see her go through a lot of things in her life and finishing her school and moving up to the north, and Adam, you following her and chasing her down. Good job, you got her. Andrea and I have seen each other through highs and lows in our life, and we've been able to console each other about the cold weather in the Arctic and that mosquito season is only half the summer. You've given me so much support and good advice that I could never repay you for. But I'm going to try and return that favor for you and Adam today. Adam, you have somehow caught a very rare woman. Andrea is now the kind of wife who would rather have a fishing rod in her hand than the latest shade of an expensive lipstick. You're a lucky man. She's the kind of wife who is right at home in the driver's seat of your quad, just in case you find, no matter the size of the mud puddle that may be in front of her. She's the kind of wife who sometimes keeps wood just in the back of her car, just in case she finds the perfect spot for a camping trip. But these aren't the reasons she's rare, Adam. She's rare because she's chosen to commit sharing each of these special experiences now with you for the rest of her life. She will always want you beside her on these fishing trips, you to hold on to while off-roading or traveling to a new destination. Your hand to hold when the night gets dark and the fire starts dying down. Please take your moments together into your hearts. The best gift I can give you guys is just three simple golden rules for a happy marriage. It can be that simple. They are respect, forgiveness, and sharing with each other. Respect each other. You will each have your own opinions and beliefs that need to be spoken aloud. Forgive each other and forgive yourselves when possible if mistakes are made. This is often easier said than done, but it helps to keep your hearts open. And lastly, sharing. This means communicating your feelings to each other if they're positive or not. Share your hopes, dreams, and your fears with each other. And please don't forget to share your love for each other. I hope you take this advice with an open heart and a glass full of wine or a Jack and Coke. So please join me in toasting Mr. and Mrs. Adam and Andrea Lindsay.
Well, thank you, DJ Dave and everybody. What a great day and a great event. So thank you very much for having all of us. Before sharing my mother's, who's also referred as Grandma Lindsay, her message, I want to offer congratulations and best wishes to both you, Adam and Andrea. On behalf of the Lindsay clan, which and those that aren't with us today, welcome, Andrea. We're so glad that you're a part of our family. And we look forward to many, 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 many family occasions, and maybe even a tube ride or two. Wild and crazy, you know the signal? It goes like this. So, like, if you want to go wild and crazy, that's all you have to do. So,
not when she's driving.
I really drive a great boat. So now here's the message from Adam's grandmother, who's 92 years old right now and in Vancouver, thinking of you both dearly. So now I'm going to have to put on my glasses here. Congratulations, Mr. and Mrs. Adam Lindsay, on this, the occasion of your marriage. On the Saturday before Easter, this brings back to me an occasion many years ago, in 1950, as also the day before Easter when James Lindsay and Thelma Jones, known to you as Grandpa and Grandma Lindsay, became husband and wife in Winnipeg, Manitoba. I have been fortunate in seeing Adam grow and develop through the various stages of his life, starting to school, continuing in further education, and then starting his career. I often wondered when he would introduce me to a very special person. I was waiting, waiting, waiting. Then the day came when he introduced me to Andrea. Since then, when we've been together, it's been a pleasure to see a strong friendship developing between the two of you. Then came the evening when I received a phone call and heard, Andrea and I are engaged. I asked her to marry me and she said yes. So I'm sure you're not only getting congratulations, but a lot of advice on living a happy married life. I would like to share with you some words your grandpa and I received, words which stayed with us all of our married life of 52 years. They were given to us by our friend and pastor who married us. They are 9 words found in the book of Ephesians and are, "Let not the sun go down on your wrath." We always remembered them. But there were times when we were a little too stubborn to apply them. On such occasions, our bedroom had a temperature like an ice box. Each of us established our own turf, each on the opposite side of the bed, as far apart as possible without falling on the floor. If that was our stance for one day, usually by the next night, the temperature started to get a little warmer in the room until finally one of us would gradually roll over and then slowly would come an apology of forgiveness and happiness was restored. The 9 words had been applied. Today you both made promises to love each other, a love developed over the years you've known each other. You realized you had become very special friends. I believe that in marriage, it's important for a husband and wife to continue to be friends. As I was thinking about some words for today, I came across a lovely little poem titled, Why God Made Friends. God made a world with a heart full of love. Then he looked down from heaven above and saw that we all needed a helping hand, someone to share with who will understand. He made special people to see us through the glad times and the sad times too. A person on whom we can always depend, someone we can call friend. Very recently, as I was cleaning out the lower drawer of my filing cabinet, just in case you wonder what Thelma's doing, so I came across a box of special cards too precious to part with. One card from your grandpa on Valentine's Day, a few months before he passed. He signed the card, not Jim, but your pal and hubby Jim. Andrea and Adam, my wish for you is that your love will continue to grow as you share your lives together, and maybe you too will remain as pals. Amen. I also found a booklet which contained our marriage certificate as well as the entire ceremony, including the vows we pledged. Here is the closing prayer. May the union of this man, Adam, and woman, Andrea, be blissful and lasting. May their mutual love never know doubt or change. May they live a long life as husband and wife together to share each other's joys and sorrows. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, everyone, just a couple quick words to kind of conclude this, and then we can chow down on some food that's been prepared. We want to thank everyone again for coming out. This has been such a special day, not only for Andrea and myself for what happened with us and entering this marriage and union, but also to share it with each and every one of you guys who's here today. We really appreciate it, and that doesn't only go for our guests, but it goes for everyone. Leah, Dan, everyone who's here right now, thank you so much for making this day so special. It's truly appreciated from the bottom of our hearts, and we are so thankful. So with that said, unless Andrea has anything else to say.
I just want to say thanks to everybody, all our family and friends for showing up and making this time quite special.
That says it all, doesn't it? Thanks, everyone.